storehouses. For he spoke and it was done. He commanded and it stood fast. Says, the counsel of the Lord stands forever, the plans of his heart to all generations, and together, blessed is the nation whose God is the Lord, the people he has chosen as his own inheritance. Praise the Lord! Let's welcome Glory Voices.
Praise the Lord! Hallelujah! We'll take the congregational hymn together this morning. We are all welcome to the second service. Then sing my soul. Hallelujah.
Oh Lord, my God, when
side of you.
Jesus Christ. for me. No one else will do.
Salvation. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Be blessed as you listen in Jesus' name.
I will lift up my eyes to the hills from when strength cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, the Lord which made heaven. The Lord which keepeth me, He will not slumber nor sleep. Oh, the Lord is thy keeper, the Lord.
has come.
My help has come. My victory has come. My light has come. My miracles have come. God, I won't run to me. The vision has come.
Is alive. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ebenezer is alive. Jesus is alive. Jesus is alive. Jesus is alive. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. You see, we can stay here and sing that song and sing it until the host of heaven descend. We can do that. But what I'm not sure is that if your faith can carry it. If your faith can carry it, we can sing that song. Someone who is sick will be healed right here. I don't know if your faith can carry it. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Father, we want to thank you. We are grateful. For we serve a God that is alive. Thank you. Others are looking for their God. Our own God has found us. So we thank you for writing our name in the book of life. We give you praise. Thank you for going to the cross. And thank you for shedding your blood on the cross for us. Today, we are alive in you. We are alive in you. We thank you. Thank you for the covenant of life, the covenant of peace, the covenant of prosperity, the covenant of success, the covenant of fruitfulness, the covenant of abundance. We thank you. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' name we worship. Amen. Please be seated. Be seated. Be seated. Glory Voices, you can take your seat. Amen. Let's celebrate. Let's celebrate God in their life. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Be filled with the fullness of the Holy Spirit. God wants us to overflow with the Holy Spirit. Part of our covenant inheritance or blessing that we have in Christ Jesus is that, one, there are many, but we can be filled with the Spirit of God. We can be filled with the Spirit of God. And the Spirit of God is a wonderful spirit. In the Spirit of God, there are embodiment of blessings, wisdom, knowledge, power, might, counsel. So you see, where if you are a believer, you are a full package. You are a full package. If you are a believer, you are a full package. If you are a sister and a man marries you, he marries a full package. And if you are a brother and you have a wife, your wife have a full package. Everything we need for life and godliness has already been given. It's been given. Absolutely given. Jesus is not going to go to the cross the second time. No. He's done it once. It is finished. And it is finished. Finished. Praise God. So our duty and our job is to lay hold, grab. If there's any other word I can use to demonstrate to you how to grab the things that Jesus died for. Because if the death of Jesus was a reality, then every blessing they die for is also a reality. Eternal life is a reality. Amen. You and I, we have eternal life. Amen. Because we are in Christ Jesus. Praise God. Be filled with the fullness of his spirit. Ephesians chapter 3, 16 to 19, that he would grant you, according to the riches of his glory, to be strengthened with might through his spirit in the inner man, that Christ may dwell in your heart through faith, that you, being rooted and grounded in love, may be able to comprehend with all the saints what is the width, the length, the depth, and the height, to know the love of Christ which passes knowledge, that you may be filled with all the fullness of God. When a man is grounded and rooted in love, you are a conqueror. Amen. I repeat myself. When a man or a woman is rooted and grounded in love, you are a conqueror. Amen. Because love does not fail. Other things may fail, but love cannot fail. Many waters cannot quench love. Amen. If you are a woman and your husband is doing anyhow, you have my permission to say, Pastor, say I should tell you that all your garagara will not quench my love for you. Many waters cannot quench love. I love you till Jesus comes. Amen. And you have, as a man, if your wife is behaving the way you don't like, there's no need to quarrel. Don't say, dear, I love you till Jesus comes. All your things you are doing to me will not remove one atom of my love for you. That statement you make will turn things around for you. You don't believe me? Okay. I wish somebody can practice it and come back and tell us. Because many times when we have conflict and we have issues with people, we want to explain ourselves out. And the more we explain ourselves out, in some people, you are digging a bigger hole for yourself. So at the end of the day, what is the purpose of your explanation? Rather, turn the table around. I say, look, irrespective of the way I'm feeling about you, my love for you, nothing kills it. And when the woman hears that, if she was maltreating you before, giving you only one piece of meat in your pot, in your soup, in your plate, she will increase it to two. Because women are moved by what they hear. And it will enter her spirit. When she's taking her bath, she will be remembering it. She's on the road, she will remember it. Amen. Now, this is not my sermon. So I believe God is speaking to somebody here. And that's how I know when God speaks to somebody, in addition to what I've written down. Hallelujah. Amen. So when a man or a woman is rooted and grounded in love, you are victorious. You are absolutely victorious. But the beauty about love is that in Christ Jesus, it helps us to be full in Christ Jesus. So we have the fullness of the Spirit of God in us. So those who are expecting and praying, Lord, fill me with your spirit, fill me with your spirit. The first point to start is this prayer in Ephesians chapter 3. That's the first place to start from. It's a prayer that Paul prayed for the saints in Ephesians church. And that same prayer is applicable to everyone here today. Amen. And we have to be strengthened with might through his spirit in the inner man. When the Bible says the inner man, is talking about, it's not talking about your physical heart. It's talking about your spirit man. So your spirit man is the inner man. Because a man is made up of the soul, the spirit, and the body. We need the body in order to live on earth. When our time of living on earth expires, we shed this body and we enter our realm, the spirit realm. Amen. So when Holy Spirit is at work in any life, the whole work of the Holy Spirit in us is, we call it the work of grace. It's the work of grace. He beautifies us. He convicts us. He justifies us. Those are the works of grace. So the desired result of this work of the Spirit is that Christ may do what? Dwell in our heart through faith. 100%. So Jesus is present when we give our life to him as a believer. But we want him to have his way and have his room in us. We want him to dwell in us richly. And when Jesus is dwelling in us richly, what we are saying to Jesus, you have my permission to rearrange my life. That's what we are saying. A man or a woman that has Jesus in him, you are telling Jesus, Lord, you are Lord over my life. Therefore, you have my permission to rearrange my life. And when Jesus, or through the Holy Spirit, is rearranging our lives, then our duty is to follow the leading. And if you find a good Christian, or if you find a believer who is in fullness of the Spirit of God, that believer has allowed the Lord Jesus to rearrange his life by the leading of the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. Praise God. So we allow Jesus to rule our hearts. And if that is the case, then that means the Holy Spirit will have to be empowered in us to break every spiritual obstacles that we want to hinder his work. Fear, carnality, self-centeredness, they all hinder the work of the Spirit of God in a man's life. So to allow Jesus to lead us in his way, because he is the way, we need the Holy Spirit enabling us to stay with him, to stay with God. And we stay in God and we stay in Jesus as we stay in his word. So if we're not staying in his word, we can't stay with Jesus. There will be a conflict somewhere. But the more we stay in God's word, and the more we pray, and the more we worship daily, and the more we have fellowship with the Spirit, the more our life is rearranged. Amen? So the outcome of a rearranged life of a believer is being grounded in love. Is being grounded in love. When you find a believer that is grounded in love, his life has been rearranged by the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. Amen. So the Holy Spirit processes is always leading to more spiritual fullness. Every one of us, we are a work in progress. The Holy Spirit is processing us. And as he's processing us, he's making us more spiritual. Amen? It's making us more spiritual as far as we give him the room to do so. So, spiritual fullness is a way of life. It is not a one-off event. Amen? Spiritual fullness is a way of life. It is not a one-off event. For example, we were told of the 500 disciples of Jesus, but in the upper room, we only had 120 there. But out of that 120 that was at the upper room, Peter was among them. And the Holy Ghost came down on that day in Acts chapter 2, 3 to 4. So there were cloven tongues of fire that was on each head. So Peter was present on that day. But then if you move further to Acts chapter 4, after he preached his sermon, 3,000 people were saved. And then the church was born. And then he preached again in Acts chapter 4. And then the elders arrested him. And they said to him, you can't preach in the name of Jesus. And Peter, remember the Bible says he was filled with the Holy Spirit. In Acts chapter 4 verse 8. He was filled with the Holy Spirit. And said to them. And after that encounter, if you remember that same chapter, he said to them, you decide whether it is better for us to listen to the voice of men or the voice of God. They said to him, we don't want to preach about the name of Jesus anymore. And like we are in this society or in our world today, not too many people want to hear about Jesus. But we have to make sure they hear it. Whichever way we can, we have to make them hear it. By the witness of our life, by going out for evangelism, by using social media to evangelize. Amen. Your Instagram page, put a word there. Your Facebook, put an encouraging word from the Bible there. That's evangelism. I'm not saying that you should create content. Amen. And if you want to create content, create a positive content that somebody will listen and be blessed. Hallelujah. I know you want to make money from that. But God will give you something bigger than that. God will bless you. Hallelujah. So what I'm saying is that Peter, again, in verse 31, when he went to his own company and they prayed together, the Bible recorded that the place was shaken because they were filled again with the Holy Spirit. Amen. So as we gather and we are worshiping God, the power of God is here, the presence of God is here, every one of us, we are being filled. Amen? So every Sunday you come to church, you are being filled. You are being cleansed. You are cleansed by the word. You are being energized to face the week. If you know you're a regular church member here, I want you to check your life. Any Sunday you are not in church, it's as if you missed out something. Because every time we gather, the host of heavens are here. And they are touching and blessing us in diverse ways. Diverse ways. They are taking things out of us that we don't even know are in us. And the things that we know that are in us that are not of God, they correct it. So you are keeping strong every time. And you are keeping a smiling face. Not that you don't face challenges, but your God has not allowed your challenges to overwhelm you. So be encouraged that your Savior is alive. Amen? Jesus is alive. Jesus is alive. Hallelujah. So it says to us in Ephesians 5:18, do not be drunk with wine, but be filled with the Spirit of God. Be filled. It's a continuous tense. It's a command. Be filled. Continuously ask for the filling of the Spirit of God upon you. Continuously. Don't feel you have arrived. Let no day pass without you asking, Lord, fill me. I need more of you in my life. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So, in the place of prayer, we ask for the filling of the Holy Spirit. And we get filled. Now, we can also get infilling of the Spirit of God when we thirst after it. Or after him. Because the Spirit of God is a person. It's not a force. It's a person. Through test. Jesus said in John chapter 7, 37 to 39, if any man thirst, let him come to me and drink. He who believes in me, as the scripture has said, out of his heart or out of his belly, and that translation says, will flow rivers of living waters. But this is spoke concerning what? The Spirit. So, Jesus expects you and I to be filled to overflow of the Spirit of God. So much so that someone standing or being in our life or being in our space will be affected by it. You know, on Friday we went out for evangelism in Liverpool. And then I handed a flyer to an old woman. She was so excited to receive the flyer off me. And I said to her, Jesus loves you. She said, yes, that's good. I said, okay. I said, do you want us to pray? Do you want me to pray with you concerning anything? He said, oh, everybody needs to be prayed for. Everybody needs prayer. I said, okay, what do you want us to pray? She said, oh, can you please pray for a family member? I said, okay, bring your hands. I held her hands and then we pray. And then by the time we finished praying, and then I said, I hope you're all right now. She said, yes, I'm okay. And then she turned and said to me, said, I sure hope that he hears the prayer we have prayed. I said to her, he has heard the prayer and he will do marvelous things. Amen. And sometimes that woman is an example of people who just come to church. They don't believe. We just have to come. If we don't come, some guys will say, we didn't see you in church. But we have to. Jesus is real. If I've not said anything to you today, please, with all my heart, I love you. But I want you to know that Jesus is real. Jesus is real. Christianity is a living relationship. Living relationship. And the thing about it is that it is how much you put into it that you get out of it. So it's not so much about the teaching priest. The job of the teaching priest is to guide you, instruct you in the way of righteousness. But then you have your own part to play to enjoy the fullness of it. Hallelujah. So through thirst, we get the fullness. What is thirst? Thirst refers to eager yearning of those heavenly blessings that refreshes and restores our inner life. Eager yearning after those heavenly blessings that refresh and restore our inner life. Such testing conditions apply to us at various times. And we must take note of that, because you are, you know, if a Christian is up today, it's good to stay up and keep going up. Don't come down. Amen? But many times life happens, and then that individual drops. But that will not be your portion. That will not be your portion. And when people drop, dryness sets in. Because it's either they are not praying that they used to pray. They don't study the word that they used to study. They don't come for fellowship that they ought to come for fellowship. They are not members of the life group. And you cannot be a member of Calvary Love City and you're not a member of a life group. You have to be a member of a life group. Because life group is a smaller portion of the church scattered all over the place. For our own good. For our own good. Because if you are celebrating your birthday, it's your life group members that will come around you. Or you have other things you need to do, or you have a need, it's the life group members. The disciples went to their own company. Please, I'm trying to encourage us. So that you don't feel lonely in the midst of plenty. You don't have to feel lonely. You don't have to feel nobody knows me, nobody cares. You don't have to. Because we have life groups. Get connected. Amen? Happy to your neighbor, get connected. Tell them so that you don't feel lonely. Because loneliness is a big problem here. I hope you know. If you visit a very elderly people, you will know that it's a problem. They will not let you go. They will not let you go. They will talk and tell you history of 1927 before you were born. Because loneliness is a problem. The government has no solution. They have no solution. How I wish you can create a solution for them and create. We have a platform here every third Saturday. People can come in here. They have tea, coffee, and biscuit and toast here every third Saturdays by 10 a.m. If you know of anyone, tell them to come here on third Saturdays, 10 a.m. We are here, giving them that opportunity to have fellowship. Amen? The Lord will help us in Jesus' name. So causes of spiritual dryness, life pressures, the pressures of life, the worries of life, the responsibilities of life, the busyness of life, the disappointment and preoccupation with earthly matters. These things, they take away from the inner man. Heavenly resources, that is for inner man. And we have to understand it and then know how to balance it and deal with it. And the way you can deal with that, Jesus said, come to me and drink. So you have to go to Jesus. We go to Jesus in the word. We go to Jesus in fellowship. We go to Jesus in the place of prayer. We go to Jesus. Prayer is not because we have a need. We pray. No. Prayer is a way of life. Hallelujah. And nobody goes to Jesus and come back home the same way. Nobody. Whoever drinks of this water will not thirst again. That's why he said, the water I will give. He said, whoever tastes of it whoever drinks it will never thirst again. We will not thirst again. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. So Jesus is there through the Holy Spirit to satisfy our legitimate thirst. is always there. The water that I will give you will become in you a fountain of springing, a fountain of water springing up into everlasting life. John chapter 4, verse 14. Hallelujah. So the Holy Spirit supplies, develop abundant life within a trusting heart. Out of his heart will flow rivers of living waters. Now, because we're talking about the fullness of the Spirit of God, how to be filled with the fullness of the Spirit of God, we must be aware of three things that we need to avoid. And many times the Spirit of God, people think it's a force. It's not a force. It has a personality, like a human. He talks, he sings, he listens, he instructs, he guides. It has a personality. And because it has a personality, three things we need to avoid is that, number one, we must learn not to resist him. Learn not to resist him. And we resist the Spirit of God when we show him attitudes that opposes his work in our lives. In Acts chapter 7:51, if you remember that place, Stephen was speaking to the people, the leaders then. He was telling them about the faithfulness of God and their own unfaithfulness towards God. And he described them. He says, "You stiff-necked and uncircumcised in heart and ears, you always resist the Holy Spirit as your fathers did." So they had attitudes that opposes the work of the Spirit of God. He called them stiff-necked. In other words, they are stubborn people. They are self-willed. Self-willed people. Stubborn and self-willed. That's what it means to be stiff-necked. The Holy Spirit prompts you, tells you to do things, you don't do it, or we don't do it. Let me not, take myself out of the equation. We don't do it. That means we are stiff-necked. We are self-willed. We always want to do our will, not the will of God. That translates to uncircumcision in our hearts. We act like people who are uncircumcised in their heart. People who are uncircumcised in their heart, they are self-willed and they are stiff-necked people. Their ears are uncircumcised. They hear, but they don't do. So they don't allow God to cut away the carnality that they carry in their innermost being. They are self-righteous people. They are self-sufficient. They are self-made. We are not self-sufficient. Our sufficiency is of God. And we are not self-made. We are God-made. Every man, every woman need to carry that mentality. That we are not self-made. We are God-made. And our sufficiency is of God, not of any man. Hallelujah. So, number one, learn not to resist the Holy Spirit. Number two, do not grieve the Holy Spirit. We can grieve the Holy Spirit. And that is because it's a personality. And the attitude that we show him can grieve him. Like bitterness, wrath, anger, clamor for evil, or evil speaking, or malice. In my early days, when we got married, myself and Pastor Mrs., reasoning. We reason together. We don't quarrel. We reason. Praise God. We don't quarrel. We reason. We reason. Because the Bible says that the bishop should not quarrel. Yeah. So we just reason. And in those days when my reasoning and her reasoning are antagonistic, that was antagonistic and it's not aligning. Yeah? And I want to go and pray. As I kneel down to pray, the Holy Spirit will say, "My son, stand up. Don't waste your time. Go and align your reasoning with her." And then I will say, "Lord, I'll just do, you know how man will do like this." And then I'll just say, "There, this matter. What do you want us to do now?" And then we'll just resolve it. And then I'll go back to pray. And it's as if weight is lifted off me. And that's how you know when your harmony between your wife is free-flowing. That's how you know when you kneel down to pray, nothing that the Holy Spirit brings to your mind. You feel all right. You feel cool. Amen. So let's not grieve the Holy Spirit. We must not grieve the Holy Spirit. If somebody is harboring bitterness with you and you are aware of it, go and make peace with them. It doesn't reduce you. Make peace with them. Okay? Number three, do not quench the Spirit. 1 Thessalonians 5:19. 1 Thessalonians 5:19. When Paul wrote to the saints at Thessalonica, he instructed them, do not quench the Spirit. Just as a fire can be quenched, the promptings of the Holy Spirit can be stifled. In other words, it can be quenched. What does that mean? The promptings of the Holy Spirit. What is it about? You see, as we read the Word of God, and the Spirit of God begin to open up our understanding in some areas that we need to make amends. That's a prompting of the Spirit of God. And all we need to do in order to respond to that prompting is to make that adjustment. And that's how we grow in the Spirit. But anytime we get that prompting and we don't do anything about it, or we procrastinate, I will do it later, and we never do it, we are not growing. Amen. When the Lord is putting in your heart, stand up and pray, wake you up in the night to pray, pray, pray. And you say, Lord, there's no need to pray. I'm not in trouble. That's the prompting of the Holy Spirit. You need to wake up and pray. Even if you can't do 4 hours, at least you can do 1 hour. He will understand and supply strength. But when he wakes you up, you turn to the other side of the bed. And he wakes you up, you turn to the other side of the bed. He will just leave you to sleep and wait for you until the situation will become worse. But our situation will never be worse. Amen. We will respond positively. Amen. To the Spirit of God. Amen. Amen. Praise to God. So, as I conclude, it is the will of God that we walk in the daily dependence upon the Holy Spirit. It's God's desire that we seek Him for the fullness of the Spirit's work in our lives. We need, just like we are seeking the blessings, also we need to seek the fullness of the Spirit of God in us. In us. We must seek it. Or seek Him. Seek Him. And when a man is being filled of the Spirit of God, what is the result? Pastor, what is the result? You've been saying in the last 40 minutes or so, we should be filled with the Spirit of God. We should be filled with... Then what is the result? In addition to the fact that you've told us, okay, we know we have the Spirit of God, but what else? There's something else. Ephesians chapter 5, 18 to 21. Ephesians 5, 18 to 21 gives us a broad perspective on the result of being filled with the Spirit of God. It says to us, speaking to one another, in verse 19 to 21, says, speaking to one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord, giving thanks always for all things to God the Father in the name of Jesus Christ, and submitting to one another in the fear of God. Those are characteristics of a man who has the fullness of God in them. You submit to one another in the fear of God. Submit to one another in the fear of God. You don't submit to pastor alone. Submit to your spouse. Submit to your husband. Submit to your wife. As a man, you need to submit to your wife in the fear of God. So, but pastor, what about that scripture that says that the man is the head of his wife? It is true. The man is the head of the wife. But also, Christ is the head of the man. So when you are submitting to the man, you are submitting to Christ. If Christ is the head of the man, so also Christ is the head of the woman. Because woman is not in isolation. Amen? There's nothing wrong in a man apologizing to the wife when you are wrong. There's nothing wrong. It's not the woman's job all the time to say, I'm sorry, darling, even when she's not wronged. You are the one that created the problem. You still want her to apologize. And you say you carry the Spirit of God? It's not deep. Amen? All you need to do is let the Spirit of God speak to you. You are the one that is wrong. There, I'm sorry. Settle it. Reason together. Align your thoughts together. Giving thanks always for all things. Give thanks to God in everything. Amen. Thank Him in everything. You wake up in the morning with a song in your heart. It's the Spirit of God that's putting that song in your heart. Sing it. Sing it all day. If possible, sing it all day. Hallelujah. Read the book of Psalms to yourself. Say, speaking to one another in Psalms. You can read it to yourself also, and read it to somebody else also. Read it to yourself. Hallelujah. So we conclude today by saying that we are part of this service is the anointing service, whereby we anoint with oil. And when we anoint with oil, we believe that the power of God will descend. We believe that the Spirit of God will come down. And the person that is anointed will be filled with the Spirit of God. Because in 1 Samuel 16:13, it tells us there that as Saul anointed David, the Spirit of God came down upon him from that day forward. So physically, it's just oil on the head of David. But spiritually, the Spirit of God came down upon him. If you desire the fullness of the Spirit of God, you can get a measure of it today. Amen? Praise God. And the oil we are using here is simple olive oil. We have not taken it to any coven. Somebody may take a caveat. It's simply an olive oil, but we have prayed over it and asking that it becomes for us a holy anointed oil. Amen? And as we put it on you, expect something to happen. Whatever it is you are believing God for, expect it to happen. Praise the Lord. So let's be upstanding. Let's thank God. Remember, be filled with the fullness of the Holy Spirit. Go ahead and thank God for His word. So what we'll do is that we'll anoint and then we'll pray together. Now, if you are in the first service and you want to be anointed, you are not anointed in the first service, and you're asking, Pastor, can I be anointed again? Yes, you can, if you want. And if you are in this service and you are not confident in what we are talking about, and you don't feel like being anointed, there's no hard feeling. Remember, it's a thing of faith in the heart. Just take your seat where you are if you are not interested in it. But for those of us who are interested in it, I join my faith with yours that as the oil touches your head, the Spirit of God comes upon you. The power of God comes upon you. In the name of Jesus. The children have been anointed already. Do you have some there? Okay. Yes, please. Believe God, just believe God. Mashaka Tabarano. Let's pray in the spirit. Let's pray in the spirit. For those of us who can pray, go ahead and pray in the spirit. Mashaka Tabaranos. Lekete sekete lebragado shaka tabarano. Elegado zebarana ekombarano sekele. Mande. Receive the fullness of the Spirit of God. 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 In the name of Jesus, receive the fullness of the Spirit of God. In the name of Jesus, receive the fullness of the Spirit of God. In the name of Jesus, receive the fullness of the Spirit of God. Receive the fullness. I've already put it. Receive the fullness of the Spirit of God. Receive the fullness of the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. Receive the fullness of the Spirit of God. 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 Receive this fullness of the Spirit of God. Receive the fullness of the Spirit of God. Masagadagalagados. Mandegeligada satayana. Mali progosogon. Receive the fullness of the Spirit of God. Receive the fullness of the Spirit of God. Masagadabarana. Mandali progosogon. Makadadala. Sekelebrando. Receive. Receive. Masekelebrando. Receive the fullness of the Spirit of God. Rekasatabaradosiane. In the name of Jesus, receive the fullness of the Spirit of God. Receive the fullness of the Spirit of God. Masatabaranos. Nebrogoshande. Nebrando. Receive the fullness of the Spirit of God. Receive the fullness of the Spirit of God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, receive the fullness of the Spirit of God. In the name of Jesus, receive the fullness of the Spirit of God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, receive the fullness of the Spirit of God. Receive the fullness of the Spirit of God. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. Receive the fullness of the Spirit of God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, receive the fullness of the Spirit of God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you. Jesus, thank you. Thank you. In the name of Jesus, receive the fullness. Receive the fullness. Receive the fullness. In the name of Jesus. Receive the fullness. Receive the fullness. In the name of Jesus. Receive the fullness. In the name of Jesus. Receive the fullness of receive. Receive in the name of Jesus. Receive in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. The fullness of the Spirit. Receive the fullness in Jesus' name. Receive the fullness in the name of Jesus. Receive the fullness. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Receive the fullness. Receive the fullness in Jesus' name. Receive the fullness in the name of Jesus. Receive. Receive the fullness in the name of Jesus. Thank you. Receive the fullness in the name of Jesus. Receive. Receive. Receive the fullness in the name of Jesus. Receive. Receive. Receive the fullness in the name of Jesus. Receive the fullness. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Receive the fullness of Jesus. Receive. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Receive. Mazagadagalabaros. Receive the fullness in the name of Jesus. Lekasatabarano. Seketedibrando. Mandagadagadiabaranos. Shekotogoborono. Sekedegadagadi progosododo. Mandagadagadi prono. Receive the fullness. Receive the fullness in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Receive the fullness. Rekasakatala. Lekeseketedi. Mandagadabaro. Receive the fullness in the name of Jesus. Receive the fullness of the Spirit of God in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Mazagadagada. Mali Bragado. Zegedegade. Proko Shandaraga. Mandagalabaranos. Thank you, Lord. Mazegedegade. Receive. Receive the fullness. Receive the fullness in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Receive the fullness in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Receive the fullness in the name of Jesus. Receive the fullness in the name of Jesus. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. So we are going to pray together now. Romans 8:11. But if the Spirit of Him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, He who raised Jesus Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies through His Spirit who dwells in you. As death and grave could not hold Jesus down, by the power of the Spirit, by this anointing, no schemes of hell or agenda of the devil can hold you down. So we are praying together, as death and grave. Say after me, as death and the grave could not hold Jesus down, by the power of the Spirit, by this anointing, no schemes of hell or agenda of the devil can hold me down anymore in the name of Jesus. Go ahead and pray. Shakatakata barabara. Mali broko soko torindene. Mande ketende bragados. Manda gadaga barados. In the name of Jesus, nothing will hold me down anymore. Masekete marabarado. I rise. This anointing is on my rising. It is on my rising. It's on my rising. In the name of Jesus, I arise. Masakata barado. Mande ketele bragados. Mazagada gadabara. Male broko zogodom. Ela bragado shakatabara. Mande ketele bron. Ela bragados. Ela bragadasa. Ela broko zogodom. Mande ketele brandom. Makata zagadabarum. Mande ketele broko zogodom. Ela bragado shakatabaro. Mande ketele brandom. Mazagada galibrom. Mazokoto lebran, magada gabaradosam. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. We are praying by this anointing that I've received. I receive fresh infilling of the Spirit of God in its fullness in my life, in the name of Jesus. Go ahead and pray. By this anointing, I receive a fresh infilling of the Holy Spirit, resulting into the fullness of the Spirit in my life, in the name of Jesus. The fullness of the Spirit is my portion. The fullness of the Spirit is my portion. Male broko sakatabara, ele broko sokotoriam, ele bragado shakatabaro, male broko seketele brandim, mande ketele broko sakande, ele broko zagadagadim, masokotole brandi, ezegedegele bragadosa, ele bragado shakatabarani, ele broko zokotole brandum, manda katale broko zagadim, ele bragado shakatabarani, ele broko zogodum. Thank you, Jesus. Blessed be your holy name. The fullness of the Spirit is my portion. In the name of Jesus. Masakatabaram. Thank you, Lord. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Isaiah 10:27, and shall come to pass in that day, that is today, his body shall be taken away from off thy shoulder, and his yoke from off thy neck, and the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. You are praying as I'm anointed. I ask and decree that every yoke in my life be destroyed. My body receive healings from sickness and disease. In the name of Jesus, go ahead and pray. As I am anointed today, I ask and I decree that every yoke, whether I know them, whether I am not aware of them, today they are destroyed. They are destroyed. They are destroyed by the reason of the anointing. In the name of Jesus, every sickness, every yoke of sickness, every yoke of disease, they are hereby broken. In the name of Jesus, Masakatabaram, Malekopalia, I am healed in my mind, I am healed in my body, I am healed in my bones, I am healed in my blood, I am healed in every cell in my body, in every cell, every tissue, every muscle. I am healed. Masakatabara, mandekete kaladasa, eleko palano, ezeketem, mako sakatabaradi, esiketelum, mako papalanosam, elembrondo shatam, mandekete lebragadosa, lebragado shakatabara. Thank you, my Father. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we are praying. Luke 4:14, then Jesus returned in the power of the Spirit to Galilee. And the news of him went out throughout the surrounding regions. And he taught in their synagogue and being glorified by all. We are praying, Father, in the name of Jesus, as I'm anointed today, I declare the manifestation of the fullness of the Spirit in my life, in the name of Jesus. By this anointing, I receive speed to fulfill my destiny. I am launched into my full potential. I'm raised unto maturity. In the name of Jesus. Go ahead and pray. Masaka Tabarados. Eka Paparano. Mande Koto Soto. Ezegede. Ezegede. Mako Palia Barade. Ela Broko Sokondom. Manda Katabarados. Ele Broko Zogodom. Jaka. Ele Kete Zegedem. Maso Koto Lebrade. Eragada Zagadagada. Zagadagadigadagadigadagadigada. Lekata Zagadagadigadagadigada. Maso Koto Lebragados. Erakato Seketem. Mako Sokata Barade. Ela Bragados Shakate. Mako Sugede. Eragabarada. Ezugede Galadom. Maso Koto Lebrande. Lekoto Sekete Lebragados. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. I just give you just 1 minute. Speak to the Lord. Speak to the Lord. Something is upon you now. Speak to the Lord. The hand of God is upon you now. The power of the Spirit is upon you now. Speak to the Lord. Your own personal intention. Go ahead and speak to the Lord. Confront that situation now. In the new power of the Spirit. By the power of the Spirit. Confront it now. Mashaka tabarados, masekete kete kete, lekata sakatabara, malikoto lebrogo sokoto, shekete kete bara, shekoto lebroga zagada. We bring an end to that situation. We bring an end to that situation. In the name of Jesus, O ye mountain, you shall become plain before Zerubbabel, not by power, not by might, but by my spirit, say the Lord. Leka sakata barados. Shekete ketegara. Every limitation is broken. Every underachievement is broken. Leka sakata barado. Mali broko sokotor in the negative. Thank you, Jesus. Begin to thank God. Thank you for answers to your prayers. Thank you, my Father, as I declare over you, in the name of Jesus, as we celebrate Easter, which is the resurrection of the Lord, I decree every power holding you back or every power limiting your greatness, they are hereby defeated. In the name of Jesus, you are released to reach your full potentials. In the name of Jesus. By the reason of the anointing today, you will enjoy the manifestations of the fullness of the Spirit in your life and in your family. In the name of Jesus. And for us as a church, we enjoy the fullness of the Spirit in the name of Jesus. By the reason of the anointing upon you today, every limitation, whether physical, whether spiritual, whether material, whether marital, whether emotional, every form of limitation is hereby broken in the name of Jesus. The worst situation of a man, God can make it right by his power. Therefore, every situation that the devil meant for evil, for you, God will turn it around for your good. God will turn it around for your good. My God will turn it around for your good. In the name of Jesus. And it shall be for his glory. In the name of Jesus, I decree the supernatural resurrection and restoration of every good thing in your life. In the name of Jesus, I decree restoration of anything good that you have lost in your life and in your family. I decree that restoration now. In the name of Jesus, receive all the fullness of the Spirit. In the name of Jesus, receive joy. Receive gladness of heart. Receive the heart of thankfulness. Receive liberty. Receive wisdom. Receive skills. In the name of Jesus. Receive faith to mount up as wings like eagle. In the name of Jesus. Anything that is terrorizing your faith in God, they are hereby squashed in the name of Jesus. You will step on them. In the name of Jesus. As David stepped on the head of Goliath, and cut his head off. So also that situation, by the reason of the anointing today, you step on it. Amen. And you destroy it. Amen. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Victory is yours. Amen. Receive that victory in the name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you, precious Father, for you have had us, oh God. Glory be to your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Give God thanks. Celebrate God.
Hallelujah. Just briefly, shall we stretch our hands to our pastor and ask that the Lord will refill him. He will continue to fill him with his anointing. He will not run dry. As he's prayed for us, the Lord will lay his hand upon him. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Hallelujah. It's time for offering. Offering time. Hallelujah. Shall we fill our envelopes? If you have filled your envelopes, let's rise to our feet and lift our envelopes up as we pray. Hallelujah. Shall we rise to our feet? Amen. Our Lord and Heavenly Father, we thank you for this time. We thank you for your blessings. We thank you for all you have given to us. We come to you this day as we give of what you have given to us. Lord, we pray that you will open the windows of heaven. Pour down your blessings upon us as individuals, as families, and as a church, Lord Jesus. Thank you for we know you've heard us. Provide for everyone who have none. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. He's alive.
Amen.
He's alive. Jesus is alive. Forever he's alive. He's alive. He's alive. Jesus is alive. Forever he's alive.
kindly take our seat, except for if you are worshiping with us for the very first time, kindly keep on standing if you are worshiping for the very first time. Anyone in the foyer? Okay, there is none. Thank you very much. Glory voices. Please let's take note of the following announcement. Good news. Festival of Life comes to Manchester on Friday, 26th of April. Media, please help us with it. And the theme for this event is Let the Wind Blow. Please plan and prepare to attend for diverse encounters with God. Our beloved Father, Daddy G.O., will be ministering to all of us and by God's grace. And our great minister, Dunsi Oyikan, will be ministering as well. Hallelujah! Thank God I don't have to mention a lot of names. There is all resounding youth supposed to kindly take note of this, that there will be a brief but very important meeting for all youth and single, so and married youth as well. We are kindly meeting at this side of the church right after the second service, right after this service. Good news. Wednesday is Holy Communion service. So on the first Wednesday of every month is Holy Communion service. We meet on Zoom, on church Zoom at 7 p.m. Please connect as we reenact our covenant with our covenant-keeping God as we partake of the body and the blood of Jesus Christ. Amen. Ushers, in that regard, ushers will be distributing the Holy Communion for us for the Sunday meeting. Next Sunday is special Thanksgiving service. Hallelujah! It's a supernatural service, like an extraordinary one. Let all return with a heart full of gratitude to God as we celebrate His mercy over and over towards us. Amen. Hope Life Group. Okay, so there is Easter Connect for all Hope Life Group members. So you are kindly. Okay, so because I know that my life group is also meeting, we have Easter Connect. So Hope Life Group plus Love Life Group, please, there is Easter Connect lunch after this service. Kindly wait only for Hope and Love Life Group. No registration today. Testimony time. Testimony time. We've got three testifiers. We have the Igbos. Okay, the Igbo, Sister Precious and Brother Bright, Brother Robert, Sister BC, and then Sister Viola. Please, the Igbo. Can you please come up?
Praise the Lord. Okay, we've just come to appreciate the name of God as a family. Our current visa is supposed to expire June. That's like in 2 months' time. So, and my employer, I've been battling with them. They should give me sponsorship, but we've been on it even before I went on maternity leave, and they kept telling me that it's only if you are working from the group level, that's when they can give you sponsorship, which is in London, and I don't work in London. So, and as God we have it, even after a whole 1 year that my husband was looking for a job, and God did it, and to God be the glory, His own job is what provided us the sponsorship. And he's even still on probation. He has not even finished probation. So the way God did it, it's just that. I'm not going to take time. But it's just that the way God did it, because even when he got the interview for the first interview, he told them that he would be needing sponsorship. And was even hoping that they were not going to call him for the second interview. But as God will have it, they called him for the second interview. And even at that, they were even saying that they can't offer us the sponsorship right now. He was even very angry that time. We were still at the hospital when he did the interview. So, and I just told him, you should just, let's keep trusting God. The job offer came. And when we even gave the, he spoke with the HR as well that we need sponsorship again, they said no, that they are not going to give him sponsorship. So as God we have it, God led him to the person that recruited him. So it was the one that now directed him to the person that is in charge of recruitment, that is in charge of sponsorship in the company. So, and even his director was the one that was running after the whole thing. He took the thing up on his head. I just want to appreciate the name of God. That God did it. He did it. And they even asked that how many years. They didn't even say, okay, we are giving you 1 year. How many years do you guys want? And God did this. We got 5 years COS. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. We thank God for establishment. Sister BC.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I've come to return all the glory and honor and praise to the Lord God Almighty for the first quarter of the year 2024. God has been awesome to me personally and to us all. And I don't want to take it for granted. God has been good. Good. And I mean very good. He has been faithful. He has never failed. His love has never failed us in Calvary Love City. So I'm delighted today to say thank you, Jesus, for each and every moment of the first quarter of the year 2024. Father, please take all the glory and all the honor and all the adorations and all the praise for every single soul that you have brought into Calvary Love City, from the oldest to the babies in the womb, to the many babies that are yet coming in this year. Lord, we say thank you for all the abundance, testimonies, and blessings. Lord, the ones money can buy, the ones money cannot buy. We say thank you. To you alone be all the glory and the honor and the praise. Be magnified forevermore. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen, Sister Viola. Praise God. I just want to return all the glory to God and thank him for joining mercies. I traveled to Nigeria, and within my time there, I had to cover 5 states. And some of them I had to do by road because there were no flights in between states. I just want to thank God for Journey Mercies that I met my entire family, hale and healthy, nothing missing, nothing broken. And he brought me back safely to also meet my family here in perfect peace. And I just want to say thank you, Lord. Let's just rise up as we round up with service and thanking God for all the testimonies. Father, we bless you. We worship you for these testimonies. Be thou exalted in Jesus' name.
Why not go ahead and appreciate the Lord? Just give him praise. You are next in line for your own testimony. Father, we want to thank you. We are so grateful. Take all the praise. Thank you. Thank you for all that you have done for us, oh God. Thank you. We are ending the first quarter on a high note. Thank you for the second quarter. We are grateful for the great things that are ahead of us. Great testimonies. Thank you, Father. Greater testimonies, oh God. We are grateful. We are grateful, Father. Thank you for the gift of life, sustenance, provision, open doors, establishment. We are grateful for healings, for deliverances, for health, oh God, for wealth, Lord. We are grateful. Thank you for our children. Thank you for the babies that are born. Thank you for the babies that are in the womb. Thank you for the babies that are conceived. We are grateful, Father. Thank you for the men, the women. We are grateful for the youth and the singles. We are so, so grateful, Father. Thank you for your provision. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for making a way where there is no way. We acknowledge your help, Father. Without you, we know we can do nothing. But with you, oh God, protocols are turned around for our good. Thank you. Policies are changed for our good, oh God. We are grateful, Father, for breaking barriers on our behalf. Thank you, Almighty Father. Thank you for establishing us new doors, oh God, of opportunities, Lord, of increase. We are grateful. We are grateful. We are grateful. Father, we travel to and fro. Thank you for journey mercies, oh God. To you alone be all the praise. Blessed be your holy name. Accept our thanks in Jesus' name. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon you. May the Lord be gracious unto you. May he give you joy. May he give you peace. May he give you rest. on every side. May he give you victory. In the name of God the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name. Thank you, everlasting Father. We ask, Lord, that the lines will fall for us in pleasant places. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, oh God, for what a time we've had in your presence. To you alone be all the praise. Thank you, Jesus, because you are the resurrected Savior. Thank you because you are alive and we are alive in you. Blessed be your holy name. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Shall we share the grace in fellowship? May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our lives, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. 2024, our year of divine dominion. 2024, our year of divine dominion, and our year of divine dominion. Together, nothing missing, nothing broken. Shalom. God bless you.